Good morning, children. Welcome in today's session. Today we are going to revise some of the point of lesson number 7, that is air and water. You know, children, water has many impurities. The purest form of water is rain. Rainwater is always pure. But whenever rainwater comes down, it dissolves into many of the impurities which are present in the environment. It dissolves into the dust particles, and when it comes down on the ground, it dissolves into many pebbles and other kinds of impurities also. That's why rainwater, when it comes down, it becomes impure. The impurities which are present into the water, they are of actually two types. Some of the impurities, they are dissolved into water, and some does not dissolve into the water. So the impurities which dissolves into the water, they are coming into the category of soluble impurities, just like salt and minerals. You have seen, children, when you dissolve salt into water, it easily dissolves into water. Insoluble impurity which do not dissolve in water. So in the insoluble impurities, what are categorized? Some of the small stones, sand, pebbles, and some of the disease causing germs also come into this category. You know, children, in our homes in the previous time, our mothers, they used to boil the water. That was the very easy method. I should say that was the easiest method to purify water. Why? Because boiling kills the germs which are present in water, and easily it purifies water. Nowadays, in place of that, what we are using? We are using many chemical methods, or we are using RO water purifiers at our homes. Most of the people in their families, they are using RO water purifiers, and chemically also we remove the impurities from water, like chlorine we are using. Okay. Other than that, in some cases we are using ultraviolet radiations to purify water, which comes into the RO system itself. In this module, I am going to explain about the water impurities and how to purify water by different methods. So let's see. Soluble impurities can be dissolved by these methods, that are evaporation and distillation. What is evaporation? When liquid is heated, it converts into vapor. When it converts into the vapor, we get its purest form. So the method of changing a liquid into its vapor by heating is called evaporation. When the whole of the liquid is vaporized, the soluble impurities, they left behind. Now in this case, we get the soluble impurities behind, but our liquid goes up, it gets evaporated. Okay. So just for that, we are using the process distillation. Okay. Distillation, in this method, what we are doing? In this method, we are changing a liquid into its vapor, and then vapors are condensing. Okay. That vapors are condensing to get the pure form of liquid, and that pure form of liquid is called distilled water. Okay. And this process is called distillation. In distillation, because we are boiling water, we are converting the water into the water vapors, and those water vapors are again condensed, and we are getting that condensed water in the form of its purest form. We have advantage of distillation over the evaporation, that in the evaporation we are not getting the liquid back, but in the distillation we are getting it back. Okay. Now, insoluble impurities. To separate the insoluble impurities, we are using some of the physical methods, that are sedimentation, decantation, and filtration. So, one by one, I will explain you the methods. Sedimentation. So what does it mean by sedimentation? See, sedimentation is the method in which when I will take a jar and in this jar I will take some water. In this water I will put some of the soil. I will mix the soil into it. Okay, I will leave this jar for some time undisturbed. When I leave this jar undisturbed for some time, because the soil particles are not dissolved into the water, that's why they settle down at the bottom. Okay, so these are the impurities which settle down at the bottom and clear water comes up. So the process in which the clear water comes up and the impurities settle down when we leave the jar undisturbed for some time, this process is called sedimentation. Now in the next method, what we are going to do, without disturbing this jar, I will take this jar and from this jar I will just take this water and I will transfer this water in another jar without disturbing it, so that these soil particles will not get mixed with this clear water. So this process of transferring the clear water into the another jar without disturbing it is called decantation. So both of them, they are the physical methods by which we are removing the insoluble impurities which are not dissolved into the water. The third method is filtration. In filtration process, what we do, we take a funnel and we just keep this funnel, stand this funnel on a stand. Okay, I will keep a jar under it and I will put a rod on it. Here I have to take one filter paper and I have to fold that filter paper and I have to put that filter paper over here. Filtration is the process in which we are removing the insoluble impurities with the help of filter paper. So when we will put the liquid over here, when the water which is having insoluble impurities, I will put slowly drop by drop over here. It comes over here and insoluble impurities started collected over here into the over the filter paper. And the liquid water, it comes down and started collecting at the bottom. So this is the beaker. Here you are having filtered water. Okay, this is your filter paper and this is the funnel and these are the impurities which are collected over the filter paper. So the impurities which we are not able to separate by the method of sedimentation and decantation, we get the water. That water is now filtered and by the process of filtration, now we get the clear water. Still we are having some of the impurities which we cannot separate by these physical methods, that is germs. Germs are present in water and those germs can be separated by boiling. Boiling is the best method to remove the germs. So I think you understood how to purify water by different methods. Thank you so much.